To see the pictures is to realize how close the Trans Mountain Pipeline came to disaster. In the Coldwater Valley near Merritt, flooding exposed lines of pipe normally buried underground.
Which then leaves it vulnerable to, you know, being hit by falling rocks or other debris that might cause either a small leak or a complete break in the line.
After the flooding, Trans Mountain shut down the pipeline as a precaution. No breaks or spills have been detected so far, but parts of the network accessible in places only by air have needed extensive repairs. The company says rain and snow are now making it difficult for this work to proceed, prolonging the pipeline's longest shutdown in its nearly 70-year history.
While construction on the Trans Mountain Pipeline expansion project is continuing in areas not impacted by flooding, here in Abbotsford, work has stopped.
To help maintain BC's supply of gasoline, refined fuel has now been barged in from the U.S. But without pipeline access, Alberta producers are now forced to store an oversupply.
It hurts, and the more days it's down, the more inventories are going to back up in the Alberta region. And when inventories back up and tanks fill, that leads to wider differentials and lower prices.
The Trans Mountain Pipeline opened in 1953 and experienced leaks and damage due to landslides within its first full year of operation. Between 1961 and 2013, there have been 81 spills along the lines of various sizes, with one of the largest occurring after a landslide near Merritt in 1971. That spill caused the pipeline to shut down for a week. This time, with more rain in the forecast, the pipeline will likely be down for 2 weeks or more.
The only thing I think we can say for sure is that if this kind of weather and these kinds of unstable conditions become more common, then closures of the line are likely to be more common.
Raising questions around whether this pipeline can remain viable if this becomes our new climate reality. Heather Urix-West, Global News, Abbotsford, BC.